So I'm always thinking about ways to maximize my profits in the stock market, ways to learn more about the stock market, how I can better myself, and how I can put out better content. And I was like, okay, I love psychology, but could psychology be applied to the stock market? Is there a psychology of the stock market? Now, I'll give you 2.5 seconds to answer that question. And let me know what you think down below in the comments. But I really wanted to discuss this because it's like, actually, the stock market really does have its own psychology. People really do behave in a way that can be very predictable. For example, the stock market has been pretty volatile the past couple weeks. But most of the time, a lot of people that don't understand the stock market end up buying high and selling low. And I think that's one of the psychologies of the stock market, and the people who don't understand the stock market end up doing this, and it is so bad for you. And that's why I really preach and talk about taking your emotions out of your investments. Of course, you're a human being, so sometimes those emotions will come into play, but most of the time you want to avoid that. Number two, another psychology of the stock market is literally everybody does what everybody else is doing. I try to avoid this. That's why most of the time the people that comment on my videos are usually like, sometimes the stuff that I talk about, I've not really seen them be talked about because I don't really follow what everybody else is doing. Sometimes it just so happens that I find something and it's also trending at that time. But most of the time I try to steer away from talking about things that are trending, because then first of all, if a stock is trending, how are we going to buy low and sell high? We're not, right? So you want to avoid the herd mentality. Stop getting influenced by other people or other investors or YouTubers. Even though I make these kinds of videos, it is always important to understand and follow your own strategy. You need to create your own strategy that works for you. Brown Asset Management is a small channel that I really love, and he has his own 6 to 7 steps or strategies that he uses to pick a stock. So I will link down a video by him in this video. But another psychology of the stock market is you have to invest consistently. So you can't just invest $100 and come back in 3 months and expect that $100 to grow, because you need to check your portfolio. You need to check the stocks in it, because sometimes things about a company can change and you need to reevaluate. So you don't want to do that. You want to build wealth by investing consistently and increasing your investment amount continuously. So when I first started investing, I started to invest, the first thing I ever invested in was Bitcoin back in 2017, and I got that for $50. So today you'd be surprised how much money I put into a stock. I have put over $10,000 in one stock. I have put over $1,000 in one stock. So as we can see, I have increased the way that I invest. I have not just invested $50. Even though you can build wealth by investing $50, let's say per week, per month, or whatever that works for you. Another psychology of the stock market is thinking long term. This is so important because a lot of people sell their stocks too soon, and that we miss out on massive gains. I do not trade at all. I'm more of a long-term trader, or not traders, more of a long-term investor. I usually only buy stocks that I believe in the long term. If I don't believe in it, I'm probably not going to buy it, because for me it's a waste of time and it costs me money to do that, especially since I do not have any free brokerage that I use, so I have to pay a commission for my investment. So I already discussed emotions, following what everybody else is doing, investing consistently, and thinking long term. I think if you want to beat the stock market and you want to know the psychology of the stock market, these are some of the things that you should know and look out for. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, and turn your post notifications on and subscribe. Don't forget sure to subscribe, like this video, and turn your post notifications on.